us, Lord, how we love you, how we worship you, how we adore you, O God, how we exalt your name, Jehovah. You are wonderful. You are great, O God. You are caring. You are loving. You are the God who watches over us, protects us, keeps us from the evil one, keeps us from harm and danger, preserves our lives, O God. We thank you. We give you praise, O dear Father. You who commanded your angels, Jehovah, to watch over us, O King of all glory, to keep us from harm and danger. Who is a God like you? You are our shield, our defender, our banner, O Jehovah, the one who covers us, the one who protects us, the one who clothes us, O dear Father. And this morning, we are grateful that, Lord, we can join online to continue praying and worshiping and loving on you, Jehovah. There is no one like you. And so be with us even as we continue praying and trusting upon you to help us to live victoriously. In Jesus' name we pray and we believe. Amen and amen. What a beautiful day that the Lord has given us. The Bible says we rejoice and be glad in it. Yes, this week, we have been looking at victorious living, and we are looking at various aspects, and we're asking ourselves, if we are to live victoriously, what do we need to do? And we've been looking at the scriptures, and day one, we looked at right believing, that if you are to live victoriously, then you need to believe right things. You need to believe the right things. And then day two, which was yesterday, I was here and I shared with us that if you are to live victoriously, then you have to see correctly, right seeing. And we looked at the story of Elisha and the servant and the army of Syria. And today, being day three, we want to say that now that we are seeing correctly, that right seeing leads to right confessing. And so today we are asking the Lord to help us to confess rightly, to use our tongues and our mouths to confess what he wants us to confess, when he wants us to confess, how he wants us to confess, and to whom he wants us to confess. Because we don't just have a mouth to speak the way we want, to whomever we want, whenever we want. No, we need wisdom so that we will confess rightly. And our scripture that will help us and guide us to pray is a very common scripture. Probably some of us don't know where it is, but you've heard it being used. It is Proverbs 18:21. This is what it says. Let me read from the ESV, then NIV. ESV says, Proverbs 18:21, death and life are in the power of the tongue, and those who love it will eat its fruits. Then NIV says, the tongue has the power of life and death, and those who love it will eat its fruit. So what is the Bible saying? Basically that this tongue that God has given us, this tongue that is so small, it's a small organ of the body, yet it has enormous benefits. It can cause us harm. It can cause us good. It can bring us good tidings. It can bring us bad tidings. It depends with the way we use it. The writer of Proverbs says that the tongue has the power of life and death, and those who love it. So those who love using their tongue correctly, those who love using their tongue in the way that God wants it to be used, they will eat its fruits. The converse is true, that those who hate the tongue and they use it to do wrong things, then there are consequences to the same. Because the writer, actually it is James, the apostle. James talks about the tongue and talks about how we are supposed to use it. Says you can use the tongue to curse, you can use the tongue to praise God. So may God help us so that we may use our tongues to confess the right things. So let us go before God and pray for our tongue. Probably we have used our tongues in frustration. We've called curses upon ourselves in frustration. We've said things that we regret saying them. And so let's go before God and ask God to forgive us and to help us use our tongue to glorify him, to honor him, so that it will bring good tidings to us. Our Father and our God, in the name of Jesus, thank you because of your word. That is, Lord, telling us to use our tongues correctly, that the power of life and death is in the tongue, and those who love it will eat its fruit, O God. And so, Lord, we are praying for our tongues, O dear Father. Lord, we want to ask of your forgiveness. Lord, we know what a blessing it is, O my Father, to speak the right things, O God. And we know how it can be devastating to speak the wrong things, O God. And so we come before you in confession this morning. Forgive us where we have used our tongues wrongly, where in frustration we have spoken words, O my my Father, that are demeaning, despising, destroying, my Father, discouraging, oh my God, to us and even to the people around us, dear Father, where we have not used our tongues to glorify you, my God, where we have not used our tongues to edify, comfort, and encourage, my Father, rather, we have used it to ostracize, criticize, my Father, and demean and despise, oh God, have mercy upon us, dear Father, where we have used our tongues, oh Jehovah, to speak doubtful words, oh God, and to cast a negative aspersions against your holiness and against your integrity and against your power. Lord, may you forgive us in the name of Jesus. I remember the story in Numbers, Lord, 13 and 14. Caleb and Joshua and the 10 spies, oh God, when they were sent to spy the land that you will give unto them, my Father, and coming back, the 10 spread a negative report, and that negative report affected the whole camp, my Father. Oh God, until you released judgment and said, my Father, none of those people are going to enter the promised land, but only Caleb and Joshua, who confessed rightly because they saw the power and the wonders of God, and they knew that it was possible for them to inherit the promised land. Father, I pray for ourselves, Lord, that you'll help us to use our tongue to speak the promises of God, to speak the victories of God, to speak the power of God, to speak the goodness of God, to speak the word of God that will never fade away, oh God. Heaven and earth will pass away, but this word will remain. Father, I pray that you'll help us to glorify you by speaking the right thing, confessing the gospel, confessing light, confessing victory, confessing the power of God, confessing coming out of darkness, confessing, Lord, being released, confessing, my Father, being set free, confessing, experiencing the favor, the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living, confessing that, God, you are turning everything around for our good. Whatever the enemy meant for evil, God, you are turning it around for our good. And so, Lord, I pray, Lord, we give you our tongues. We want to plead the blood of Jesus upon these tongues of ours, oh God. We have used them to curse. We have used them, Lord, to gossip. We have used them to tear one another apart, oh God, to speak ill of one another instead of encouraging and edifying and comforting. Lord, have mercy. We want to eat the fruit of our tongues, the fruit that is good, the fruit that is healthy. So, Lord, may you help us today, that as we march out today, as we go to our workplaces, as we go to attack the marketplace, Father, we'll use our tongue to glorify you and to honor you, to edify and comfort, that those who hear us speak, oh my Father, they shall be edified and encouraged, oh God. And so we honor you and we bless you. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, we pray and we believe. Amen and amen. Wow. May the Lord help us. This tongue, it is so small, but it can cause destruction. It can have devastating effects. Let us use it wisely. Right confessing. Go out today, confess rightly, regardless of the circumstance. Confess the word of God. Confess the promises of God. Confess what God desires for you to confess. Amen. God bless you. Have a good day.